show day. Hey guys, it's Wednesday of Peak Week. I just dyed my hair. I just did my roots. So I have, sunlight. I have gleaming black hair now. So I am in the process of washing my jewelry from my last show. And also, I got some chicken I just threw in the oven. I'm about to make the scraps for my boys while I'm gone, so they have some yummies to enjoy too. So yeah, this is the jewelry I'm washing. Clearly the water is disgusting, but a little dish soap. Basically the same way you clean your suit, you can clean your jewelry. And then you just want to rinse it off with cold water and let it air dry. I don't know what jewelry from my line I'm going to be bringing with me yet. I have yet to decide that. It's like so much stuff to do, so little time. I leave very early in the morning. These were earrings that I bought from Amazon. It's actually funny. I'll show you this. One of them broke, so I'm going to just throw them out. But look. So, this is like wish versus real life type shit, you know? So these are actually ones that I bought for myself and for my line as well, and these are like the gold version. But I'm probably gonna bring those. These are the earrings I wore my last show. I actually am gonna throw them in this water too, because you can see they're like a little dingy. And I'm gonna bring a bunch of extra jewelry just in case anyone at the show needs, you know, a last minute pair of jewelry. I'll be able to hook them up and promote my line as well. Alright, next up on the washing list is my makeup brushes. So I do the same thing. I basically just dump these bitches out in the water and then rinse them off. I just throw these in and kind of wring them out, but I do those last. So much to do. Oh, yay, yay. I am in Chattanooga. I am at the hotel gym, little fitness center. There's really nothing here except a couple dumbbells and some cardio equipment, and then there's a pool and a little jacuzzi back there. But I figured I have not vlogged all morning. I've been like on Instagram and stuff, putting stuff on my stories, but I really have been forgetting to do any vlogging, so I figured I might as well do it while I remember now. I had a very, very quick, very efficient flight from Newark this morning. I stopped off in Charleston, I think. Where? Charlotte? I'm so confused. So many towns running through my head. But anyway, I stopped off in North Carolina. I had like a 2.5 hour layaway there. Layaway, I don't even know what I'm saying at this point. Need to eat. But anyway, stopped off in North Carolina. The flight from there to Chattanooga was like 40 minutes. It had on my ticket that it was going to be like a 2-hour flight, so I prepared for that, and it was like 35 minutes, 40 minutes, so that was amazing. The hotel, I'll show you my room when I get back upstairs. It's very cute. It's a suite, so I have a nice amount of room. The bathroom is big. Yeah, so I really don't have a lot else going on today. I'm going to do my first coat of tan tonight. Finish this lift right now. I just did 30 minutes on this here treadmill. Got a little sweat going. They have a little water fountain here, so until I find like a supermarket or anything nearby, even if, I don't even know if there is one, but if I happen to find one, I will obviously get some water and stuff there. But as of right now, it's good to know that there's at least a water fountain here. I just had 2 blender bottles full of water and it tastes all right. I don't know if it's filtered, but it's better than New York tap water, taste wise anyway. So yeah, get a little shoulder pump going. And I have to shave as well. It was pretty funny on the airplane. I feel like people are looking at my legs because I have not shaved yet. Because I'm going to do all that tonight before my tan. They don't know that. They probably just think I'm some hairy bitch who doesn't care. But there is a method to the madness. I don't want to shave too early and then have to do it again and get razor burn. So anyway, let me finish this lift and I will show you the room when I get back upstairs. It's almost show day, baby. Thank you. done working out, deciding to go for a little stroll and just see what's going on around here. The guy at the front desk said that there's a Walgreens like 5 minutes away, but not 5 minutes walking, 5 minutes driving, so that means another Uber. I don't feel like doing that right now. So it's fountain water until further notice, but look how pretty this is. Tennessee River, baby. First time I have ever been in Tennessee. It's so green. It's like the perfect day too. What a great day to arrive and fly. I think it may be a little different come Saturday, but we'll find out then. Hey guys, oh my god, I'm so tired. I will hopefully try and remember to show you the room in the morning or later. It's 4 p.m. I just got back from my little stroll. I got back to the room and then I went back out and I got basically that whole container full of ice, and I'm just gonna like use that for drinking water for the time being, or go downstairs when I can to the water fountain. But I'm filled up now. I just made my third meal of the day, which is 97% lean ground turkey and jasmine rice. I just realized that I left my food scale at home. Can't find it in any of my luggage unless it's like hiding somewhere that I just didn't check, but I'm pretty sure I left it right on my counter this morning right after I made my breakfast because I weighed out my peanut butter. But that's okay, because that really is the beauty of flexible dieting and of doing this for a while, is I'm pretty good with my portions at this point. And I wasn't stupid. When I prepped my proteins, I actually portioned everything out and I put them in individual Ziplocs. So I know I have like 3.5 ounces or 4 ounces or 3 ounces of whatever. And I'm the rice that I have is like the boil in a bag rice. So I know how much I can get out of each bag. It's usually like around 5 ounces when all is said and done. So I usually get like a 3 ounce serving and a 2 ounce serving, or maybe sometimes I get 2 2-ounce servings and I have a little left over. So basically I just kind of estimated what I'm eating right now. At this point, 2 or 3 ounces of rice is not going to make or break my physique. I need to be increasing my carbs going into this show anyway, so it's okay to be a little bit over. My bad, my phone died in the middle of filming that. So anyway, plugged in my phone. I'm gonna eat this meal. I'm gonna watch some YouTube. Really just relax. I'm so tired. Really, like, that walk and that workout and that cardio just now really wiped me out. I was feeling pretty energetic before that, like, considering I've been up since 5 a.m. and traveling. But, yeah, right now I'm feeling really tired. So I may take a nap and then wake up and shower. Like, I don't even have energy to shower. I know that's really nasty that I was on planes and everything right now all day, and I should probably shower before I lay in this bed, but at this point I'm really just too tired to care. So I'll wake up, shower, and then start that tanning process tonight, probably around 7 or 8 o'clock. And yeah, it's ticking the time away at this point. I'm getting excited, more and more excited as the minutes tick on. And I'm looking good. I actually looked like really dry at the airport. I really didn't know if I was holding much water. My stomach looked drier than it ever looked. So that was good, but I figure can't hurt to get that little bit of cardio in, and it's hot out. So I got a little sweat going too when I was outside and during cardio. So that was good. Anyway, good night.
Whoa. Good morning. I am in the elevator. Clearly at the hotel.
Walking into my room. Last night I got here, you know, I showed you guys most of it. You know what? Let me hold this off. I'll give you a room tour and then I'll sit down and talk. Hold on. Alright, welcome to my humble abode. This is my kitchen. Fridge, microwave, which I mentioned in my last show day video is all you need as a competitor, so I'm okay with that. This is my area of whatever. Last night I came here and basically exploded. So I just got a little coffee from downstairs, and I picked up some like honey and random things that I might need for tomorrow morning. Here's a bunch of stuff. I bought a bunch of extra jewelry just in case anyone at the show needs it or myself. It's kind of dark in here because the sun isn't really out yet, but two beds, obviously I slept there. This is the bathroom. I really like this bathroom. Like, I would live here forever because of this bathroom. And here's all my Protan products. So yeah, hold on. So last night did not go as planned in the sense that I was supposed to do my first coat of Protan last night. And I didn't. I fell asleep from like 4 o'clock till maybe 11 at night. Like, I just needed to sleep so bad. And even after I woke up, I was like still very tired, just so lethargic, so just drained, you know, from a day of traveling, being in the heat, training. Like, you know, I was like exhausted. Like, that's not like, that's the only word that could come to mind. I was just exhausted. So actually, before I do that, let me show you my view. So this is my wonderful view of construction, which I've been hearing since 6 a.m. But we also have a little Tennessee River there, and there's a walkway, so I walked that last night, and then it leads up on the right all the way down towards a restaurant. So I kind of just went there, back and forth, and that was it. But anyway, so last night I was supposed to attempt to do my first coat of Protan, and I didn't do that. So I'm going to do that now. I actually just put an order through for Instacart to just grab a couple things like water, extra rice cakes, extra boil in a bag rice. I got eggs, banana, just things that I will need for today and tomorrow that I don't have here. I can't keep going down and filling up a blender bottle with water. That's not enough water. I need to cut water tonight at like 5 or 6 p.m. So I need to chug that shit today. But anyway, I haven't even done a physique check-in this morning. I just ran down. I woke up around like 7:30. Well, I woke up probably around 6, but I really didn't want to get up yet. So I was laying in bed hoping to fall back asleep. But even last night when I passed back out, let me shut this window because all you're going to hear is construction. But even last night when I decided to wake up and maybe go back to bed, all night it was like that sleep where like your body is sleeping, but your brain is still up type of thing. Like, I don't feel fully rested from last night, which is okay because then tonight I will get a really good sleep, which is so much more important than last night because tomorrow's show day. So I'm not sure exactly when this girl is supposed to be here with the groceries. It says any time between now and 10:40. I don't even know what time it is. It's 8:58 a.m. So if she's here by 10, that would be great. I could start my tan now, sip on my coffee, let that dry, grab my groceries whenever she's downstairs, and then I have to figure out how I'm going to concoct this today, because you really shouldn't do like 3 coats of tan in one day. So I'm going to do, obviously, I have to do one in the morning. Like, that goes without saying. I have to get my base coat on. I'm going to mix the super dark in that first coat, I think, and then do the same thing again tonight, and then assess how I look. Because you're really supposed to do it Thursday night, base coat, Saturday, Friday morning, shower that off, like just rinse it off, and then do that again for 2 more coats on Friday. So Saturday you don't rinse, you just put the top coat on. So because I missed that first coat, it's really not the end of the world. Like, that's the beauty of Protan, is like, and they're super dark, is you can use that alone and probably get dark enough. So I'm happy I bought that. I'm happy I brought that. I basically just have to assess my color as the day goes on. Really what I think I'm going to do is get this base coat on. I have check-ins at the venue between 2 and 6. So what I'm thinking I'm going to do is put this first coat on, let it sit as long as it can before I rinse. So maybe by like, if I do it by 10 o'clock, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's 8 hours. But by then, by 6 o'clock, I can probably rinse that coat off, then apply 2 more tonight, and then tomorrow morning put my top coat on. I'm hoping that works out well. I think 8 hours between first application and rinse is probably good enough, because when you think about it, when I usually get sprayed and they do the spray tan, it's usually Friday night, they'll do my base coat, and then Saturday morning I'll get 2 more coats, and it always looks fine. So I can't imagine this working any differently, being that it's the same product. But I mean, like I said, if worse comes to worse, I can always use just the super dark on its own if I don't get dark enough, and that should be good enough. Also, I checked with the Protan website, the sprayers and stuff. They don't take, they're not taking appointments right now, but they will take walk-ins. So if worst comes to worst and I need to go see the people at ProTan at the venue, I could probably walk in there for a coat just for like touch up or something like that and just wait in line. But I'm hoping I don't have to do that because that was the point of buying the DIY. So I don't have to go back and forth from here to the venue and, you know, because I'm probably like a 5-minute drive from my hotel to the venue. So although this hotel was one of the three that were affiliated with the show, it's still not connected to the convention center. So I think if I took that hotel at the Chattanooga Convention Center, I think it was the Marriott that was over there. That was the one I initially booked, but it was like double the price of this one, and this one has a refrigerator and a microwave. So I'll take the 5-minute Uber ride back and forth if it means saving $400. But yeah, so let me go get some physique check-ins, sip on this coffee. I want to take a before picture before my ProTan, after picture of the first coat, and go from there. So I'll see you guys in a bit. I'm feeling good other than being hungry, but that goes with the territory, right? So, yeah. So it looks like my Instacart order is going to be here much earlier than expected, which is good. It's like 9:05 right now, and they just said it'll be here by 9:20. So that's really nice because I also was like, I don't want to pay the extra to have it like expedited and be the first in line because I feel like no one's probably shopping right now in this area for Instacart. So why pay the extra? So I was like, I could wait the hour and a half, 2 hours, but it's like they chopped the majority of that time off. It's already on the way. So Instacart, I'm okay with you. I haven't used that app before, but for situations like this, in the middle of Chattanooga, when I have no idea where anything is and I don't really feel like exploring just to find a supermarket and stuff like that, it's nice to have these apps and the convenience like that. The beauty of technology in 2021, right? So I'm gonna wait to do my tan until after they get here, obviously, so I can make breakfast and do all that and then get that tan on. Pretty much my day revolves around my tan today and relaxing and eating. I don't think I'm gonna head out to Gold's and get a training session like in there because my tan is my priority. I have my hotel gym. If worse comes to worse, I can go down there again and get another pump. And I also have my bands. So I think tomorrow I might steal the 5-pound dumbbells that are downstairs, as long as no one else stole them first, and bring them to the show with me. So I at least have some dumbbells backstage because I feel like because I don't typically train with like bands and stuff that my body isn't used to that, and it's hard for me to get a pump by using the bands. I mean, if you do it enough, you obviously will because the blood will go into the muscle, but for me, like, it kind of just feels like I'm dislocating my shoulder more than anything when I use the bands, but I brought them anyway just in case, you know, worst came to worst. You do need something with you backstage, so yes, although you may not use those type of bands to train all the time, on show day you do want to bring them with you because you do have to pump up with something. And especially during COVID, a lot of shows are not supplying that sort of stuff backstage anymore. They used to. Most shows used to have weights and resistance bands and mirrors and stuff like that backstage, but you never know what you're going to get at shows these days. So anyway, I am going to sip on my coffee. I haven't even attempted to do that yet. Try and get this digestion moving a little bit, not to be TMI, but having endometriosis, my stomach is like also a main priority, and making sure that I am not bloated and have endobelly and like distension or anything like that on show day. So making sure that in the morning everything is taken care of, it's a challenge, especially because tomorrow the show starts at 9. It's not like my last show where prejudging wasn't until 3 p.m. for women. So I have to really get up early tomorrow, get that coffee in, do what I gotta do to really get, you know, my stomach as tiny and minimal as I can. I don't feel like right now I have much going on, but like sometimes I can't really push out, but sometimes you could see it. And it happening on show day, especially at a national show, is not the best thing. So let me get moving, get this food in my system soon, and I will be back with a pre-tanning physique update. here is my breakfast. Oats, egg whites, whole egg, peanut butter, sea salt. Same thing every day, but I don't have my Walton's Farm syrup today. So, yeah. Need to fill it out a lot more. It looks so flat. I just put my heels up to get a better look. I'm gonna eat this. Pose a little more, throw on this tan, and then chill, and then eat again. Hey guys, what's up? I am just finishing up my breakfast here, and I put on the men's prejudging. Figure might as well watch a little bit, excuse me, of the show, get a feel for what the stage looks like. Wow, I look so tired. For what the stage looks like, what the flooring is, most importantly, I really, really tomorrow do not want to shake on stage. I like want this so bad and so much that my nerves kick in really hard right before I step on stage every single time. Like, I'm very competitive. I'm a Capricorn. I want to win. I want to be first. I want to be the best. Like, I feel like if you're in this sport for fun and you're not really a competitive person, you might as well play something else, do something else. Cause this is for the pro leagues. This is for the people that don't want to make this a hobby. They really want to like move forward as a professional athlete. So with that mindset, that's where I'm at. Like, I want to take this as far as I can, you know, like who wouldn't? So I am just trying to think about how I could be my best and not be nervous tomorrow before I step on stage. You know, some people will, let me put this down. Hopefully that stays. You know, some people will, like, drink a glass of wine or take a shot before they go on stage. I probably won't do that because I'm not a big alcohol person, and, I sometimes have adverse effects on my body when I drink alcohol. I get sick and nauseous, so I don't want to do that, obviously, right before I step on stage, but I just want to, like, be able to walk out on this amazing stage. This is what it looks like. So I think we're going to be entering from the middle bikini. I would have to imagine they're going to have us enter from the middle and maybe leave through a side. I don't know. There's also no athlete meeting tomorrow. I actually messaged NPC Junior Nat's Instagram page because they've been very good about posting everything and reposting athletes and stuff like that. So I figured might as well ask them. They said that there's no mandatory meeting this year. So maybe right before we get on stage, they'll tell us how to walk out or wherever they're going to have us do it. But I do remember Sandy saying, women, we're walking out from the middle. Now, I've been watching the men, and they're typically entering from here and leaving from here. They haven't even been utilizing the middle of the stage, so maybe that's just for the women so we could do our walk. Because really, when you're an IFBB bikini pro or wellness pro, you do that walk anyway. Like, so might as well test us pre-going pro to make sure that we could do that walk and we look like pros. I mean, the walk is not something I'm worried about. My biggest worry is I just know from last show that the flooring was so slippery that was what made me not be able to like hold my poses as I really wanted to, because I was worried that my feet were gonna like go out from under me, because every step and every turn was so slippery that these shoes, again, they were not broken into at that point. Like, so it was just like a hard situation. I mean, I took the overall, it couldn't have been that bad, but I mean, this competition tomorrow is going to be a lot steeper than the Baltimore Gladiator. I actually see a couple, it was funny, like I saw a bunch of people from like YouTube or Instagram or wherever at the airport yesterday, and I couldn't really tell sometimes if it was who I thought it was until like last minute, and I wasn't going to like fangirl and run up to people and be like, hey, I follow you on YouTube or whatever. But I did see a couple people, and I am looking forward to hopefully making some friends tomorrow and meeting some more girls backstage. I'm gonna bring like all my extra earrings and stuff like that just in case anyone is having any last minute emergencies. And I'm thinking that, obviously, like, I want to win the overall, I want to take first, but I'm thinking that if I don't take the overall, I might give a jewelry sponsorship to whoever does take the overall, because I have the jewelry, I might as well. I actually took on Carolina, IFBB Bikini Pro, the other day. I forget what her last name is, but she's beautiful. She is, like, amazing, next level, beautiful. I also want to be a little bit like Abercrombie and Fitch with my business and only take on the most beautiful of the most beautiful, like brands ambassadors and stage light stars, because I want to really separate my business from all the other jewelry companies out there that are just like a free for all of like anyone and anyone, everyone and anyone, and like they'll sell you anything. Like, no, my company has standards, honey. Like, I only get the best of the best jewelry. I only get the jewelry that's gonna look the best on stage and be the most flattering. Like, I can't tell you, there's so many, well, there's not so many jewelry companies out there, but the few that are out there, they will pick any jewelry, like absolutely ugly, gaudy, ridiculous, tacky jewelry, and let you wear that on stage. Like, I'm sorry, but I am not gonna sell anyone anything that I wouldn't wear myself, or that a judge may be like, that ain't it, sweetie, you know? Like, no, all my jewelry is gorgeous. It is top of the line when it comes to this type of jewelry. And I wanna like be able to have the most gorgeous girls wearing it and like build a little like empire for myself, but one step at a time. So we'll see who winds up taking the overall tomorrow. Hopefully it's me, but I would be happy with just taking obviously first in my class and winning the pro card. But also, I have to be realistic. This is my first national show. I mean, I don't know what being realistic really is, but like, I wouldn't be happy with top five. Like, I'd be lying. I'd be happy, like, proud of myself to get top five at my first national show and, like, first call outs, but I would not be satisfied. I will not be like, oh my god, that was amazing. Like, I'll be like, fuck, now I gotta come back in 2 or 3 weeks for Universe and try and, like, get a little bit better. And, like, my body isn't at a point right now where I can't, like, continue competing. I feel good. I don't feel like, like dying of hunger. Like, sometimes in prep, people's cardio is so high, their training is so exorbitant, they're like eating so minimally, like not for nothing. But I'm gonna talk a little smack. Team Atlas, Laura Lee posted the other day, and I am obsessed with her. I'm obsessed with her physique. I thought she should have won Miss Olympia last year. Like, she is like next level. She's like weeks out of her show, probably like 8 weeks out or something. She's at 1,100 calories right now, and she's, like, bigger than me, and, like, more, like, heavier than me, and she's eating so much less than me, and I know that her coach doesn't really do, like, macro-based dieting and flexible dieting. He's very meal plan focused, and just eat what I fucking tell you, and that's it, which I don't love. Like, I wouldn't want to compete if I wasn't enjoying what I'm doing. Like, it's, maybe it's a different level when you get up to the Olympia, and you have to, like, I don't know, but there's Olympians that do flexible dieting, so there really is no, like, rhyme or reason behind why one is, like, more beneficial than the other, especially if you're not winning the Olympia, you know. But she got top five, which was, like, a downgrade for her, and I think it's because of this coaching, and it's really not, like, I just foresee issues, and, like, I'm a little bit intuitive in that way. Like, I would not doubt it in my mind if by Olympia this year she was having some hormonal issues that made her pull out from the show. I hope not. I mean, I hope she is continuing to compete and thrive, but it's hard to imagine that doing an hour's worth of cardio like twice a day and eating 1,100 calories is at all sustainable through the year. You know, like, maybe at the very end of your prep for the first show, and then, you know, like, you reverse into the next and stuff like that, but I just don't know. And I feel like she may already have a little bit of hormonal issue, which is why her coach is pushing all this now to, like, let's just drop calories and add in cardio and push, push, push. But when your body isn't responding as it needs to in a prep, it's because your health and hormones are not in a place to perform for you. Like, that's just mindless. And, like, it's very hard to tell an athlete you need to take a step back and fix your body, fix your metabolism, especially when they're a top-level athlete and they want to compete and win and they have goals. But if it's a matter of you showing up, not looking your best, or taking 6 to 8 months off anyway, like, and getting your body in a better place so that when you do prep, you're smooth sailing and you're linear dropping the whole way down, it is possible. I've done it myself, you know? So, I mean, I pray that there's no issues and there's no hormonal stuff, because that's hard to come back from. And my calories this prep didn't get lower than, like, 14 something. I think, 1490 or something like that was the lowest on my low carb days, which is like not that low at all, and I still got ripped. So everyone's different, but again, when your body is in a really good place, you don't have to go as hard to get the results that you want to get. My body was in a good place before I even started prep. So once I started prep, it was like, all right, word, like you're eating, you're working out, you're training, like I'm going to do this for you. But had I been starving myself before that and worried about my calories and like overtraining and doing too much cardio in an off season, once I started a prep, my body would have been like, this isn't much different from what we've been doing. So we're just going to stay where we're at. You know, like there isn't much change going on here, although you really want it, but you're doing the same thing you've been doing all along, maybe just a bit more. So it's not really going to work for you. That's how the bodies are. That's how women are. That's why people have so much trouble losing weight, because they're not thinking about what they've been doing prior to the wanting to lose weight. They're just thinking about what to do from here on out. And it has a lot to do with your previous history and your diet history. So anyway, I'm going to just finish up this food quick, sip on this coffee, and take my medicine, take my supplements, and I'm going to start my first coat of tan. Actually, I have to jump in the shower quick, just do one more once over of the Get Buff, just make sure my skin is in a good place. It feels really, really smooth. I actually shaved everything. Woo! Last night. I haven't had smooth armpits in like a week, so it's nice to be smooth again. But I shaved last night because after I woke up from my nap, I was like, oh, I have to do this tan. Like, I was kind of like mildly freaking out, but I was still so tired after I woke up that I knew that I was never going to be able to really do that tan at that hour. But I was like, I have to at least shower. Like, you know, sometimes you're like laying there and then you remember you have to do something and it kind of like kicks you in the ass and you're like, fuck, I gotta do this now, like, it's now or never. I remember at the Baltimore in March, I shaved, like, a few hours before I got my spray tan, and oh my god, my armpits were on fire for, like, 2 or 3 days, like, to the point where a shirt was like, ow, ow, like, it was just burning. So I didn't want to go through that again. I shaved last night, so by this morning, my pores are like in a better place, my skin isn't like freshly shaven, and like you give yourself like micro nicks and cuts when you shave yourself, so you gotta just let your body kind of recover from that before you throw a spray tan on. That's why guys, when they shave their face and then they'll throw on something immediately, it's like, ah, like Home Alone, you know, it's because you're giving yourself little cuts, and you may not see them, they may not bleed, but that doesn't mean they're not there. So yeah, that is something that I didn't want to make that same mistake, because also when it comes to touching up your armpit situation, when it's burning, it's so much worse, because like then the sweat kind of like coagulates right here, and then this is like no tan, super dark tan, and then regular, and like trying to buff that in, oh, it just sucks. So I don't want to do that again. Yeah, so that's pretty much it. I will see you guys in the next clip. Probably when I am about to attempt to start this tanning process. I hope I don't get tan all over the place. I'm thinking I might have to try to do it in the shower, because this bathroom is like totally white. They do this shit on purpose, hotels, so like if anyone gets anything anywhere, they'll know, like makeup, hair dye, anything. Even washing my hair in the shower last night, like I still had a little bit. You know, it's the first shampoo after I dyed it black, so you still have a little bit of purple coming out. I was like, oh, I hope this doesn't stain the walls, I hope this doesn't stain the grout, but looks alright. So I'm going to attempt to do this tan, get my day going. I'm pretty much just chilling in this room most of the day, and I'm not going far except to check-ins between 2 and 6. I don't know when exactly I'm going to go there, but I will assess that later. That is not a big deal. I'll be in and out of there, honestly, anyway. But I also think that, like, it would be smart, I know I'm rambling at this point, I don't care, this is the show day vlog, like, kiss my ass, you guys wanna watch this, don't you? But I'm thinking that once I go to check-ins, I gotta see where the Gold's Gym is in relation to the convention center. When I was in my Uber yesterday, the girl was saying, like, yeah, everything is down there in that area, this is, like, downtown Chattanooga, so if there's stuff around the convention center and it's not like scorchingly hot today, maybe I'll take a little walk around for a little bit. I was attempting to find a beauty supply store last night. There is actually one a few minutes away. So after I do my tan and I run through my posing again, I don't know if I'm gonna grab. I haven't gotten extensions yet. I mean, this is the hair situation. It's a mess right now because it's still a little wet from last night. But I don't know if I should get some clips for the back. I really don't know. But let me go get my butt moving. Try this tan, because the longer I wait, the more anxious it's making me. But yeah, so I'll be back soon. Yeah, so that's just the music from Men's Prejudging. I am not going to let that go too long because I don't want to get a copyright strike. But I just did my first coat of Pro Tan. You can tell, look at my neck and my face. I'm having a mild panic attack. I'm trying to dance through it. But I have been exfoliating for days. Let me shut this music off. I've been exfoliating for days. I've been using the Pro Tan Get Buffed exfoliator along with like a little mitt, and I've been going nuts on my body. Like, so my skin is totally smooth, so my skin is pH balanced, so I don't have anything to worry about. And then I start doing my tan. I started from the bottom up as suggested, and I get to my glutes and look, there's all these little dots on my glutes, right at the top of my glutes, and that's the only area on both sides on my whole body that I'm getting little dots. I know I exfoliated back there. I know I shaved. Like, I don't get what the fucking problem is. But I reached out to Pro Tan. I told them what was going on, and they gave me a phone number to someone named Alisa, who is like a tan coordinator, and they said text her and reach out to her. And I have not heard back yet. If she doesn't reach out to me soon, I'm probably going to give her a call. But during check-ins, when I head over to the convention center in a little bit, I believe they're going to be doing tanning there too, so I might just like walk in and ask them what they think I should do. And if worse comes to worse, they could like spray me or something like that. But from what I looked up online, it looks like that sort of thing happens from not having your skin exfoliated. But like I said, I've been exfoliating for days. So I don't know why of all areas on my body it needs to be right at the top of my glutes. Also yesterday when I was shaving my bikini line, I nicked myself like in the worst spot ever. And I was in the shower like, ow, like screaming because it really fucking hurt. And now this morning when I hit my back pose, I see a little scratch, which like you kind of have to be under to see, but that's where the judges are. So hopefully after I get another coat of tan and then the top coat tomorrow, hopefully that gets the little dots away and also kind of minimizes the look of that little red scratch, because it's really not very pretty. It looks like, it looks gross. Like, it looks like I got a cut right by my vagina. But I mean, everything that I do is a learning process with competing. This is the first time I've ever done the tan, so I mean, by the way, for the most part, aside from these little dots on my glutes, which I'm praying go away, it was very easy. I actually enjoyed doing my tan just now. It was so simple. Once you get the hang of how the liquid works and how it blends in, which takes no time at all, that's why I started from the bottom up, so it wasn't like up here from, you know, the beginning. But once you get used to it, it blends right into itself. There's like no streaks that I can see. And in a little, well, this afternoon after I rinse this off and I do the other two coats tonight, it'll probably look beautiful. The only thing I'm worried about is those little dots. I can't exfoliate again tonight. All I can do is really rinse off and apply again. So, I mean, I don't know what's going to happen. It's hard to tell. Look how cute this bikini is, though. This is from Angel Competition Bikinis. I am an Angel affiliate still until further notice, so I love this color, though. This is a color that, like, you never see on stage, and I don't know why. Like, this is the coral. This is actually, hold on, sorry. This is the coral, and this is the pink, so you could see the difference. The coral actually has, like, a purple iridescence to it, which I think is so beautiful, and they use the AB stones and connectors on the coral. This is a regular, just bottom from an actual suit, not a posing suit, just a stage suit. I got a pink suit as well that I was going to do my own what's it called, diamonds on, but I wound up just doing like half of one cup and then just not finishing. So I bring that pink bottom with me because it's a pro cut. So instead of wearing my show suit to do posing practice, sometimes I'll just wear those pink bottoms. These are the micro scoop bottoms. So on me, they're like, they look really nice. They look good. They're tiny, but on stage, they're a little too tiny for me. So this is good for like going to the pool or the beach or something like that, for tanning, but for stage it's too small. Ashley Kaltwasser actually wears a micro scoop, as they say on the Angel Competition website, and I find that when she's on stage it's very low here. I don't like that. I think that if you could see like where your pubic hairs start to come in on your bikini, it's way too low. She goes very low and it's very scooped, and sometimes there's a little bit of a gap. So I prefer just a little bit of a more professional, classy cut. So I get the regular cut, the, I don't know what they call it. It's not the high hip. I maybe should next time, but I like the regular pro cut, regular bottoms at Angel. I like them a lot. So yeah, this tan is still a little tacky. It's like hard to really sit. My like glutes are like sticking to themselves, so you stand weird. But again, I'm gonna wash this coat off a little bit later. And yeah, I'm just chilling at this point, and there's not much else going on. So, final physique check for a while, and I'll be back later. Hey guys, what's up? It is almost 1 o'clock. I'm just chilling in my room, sipping on my water, hanging out, watching YouTube. I actually just heard back from the girl at ProTan. She was very nice. She told me, calm down, don't worry about the spots. She told me to stay in touch with her throughout the day, see how my tan develops, consult with her tonight, send her a picture, and she'll let me know if I should even rinse my first coat off or not, or if I should just apply another coat. And she says she can almost guarantee that once I put the top coat on, I probably won't even be able to see the dots, especially from the judge's perspective. But I just want to make sure that it doesn't look like I have, like, acne on my butt, because that's, like, the only place these dots are appearing. It looks like maybe a few in the middle of my back, but my hair will cover that, but my hair doesn't cover the top of my glutes, obviously, so it just is, like, making me a little anxious, worrying about the tan, but I'm not gonna, like, psych myself out over it. I'm not gonna panic. There's still plenty of time, and, you know, I'll find a way to make it work. I gotta say, otherwise, like, doing the tan myself was very easy. I really enjoyed the process. I will never do a spray tan and pay for that again, as long as this all works out well. I don't know if the dots are because of an exfoliation issue or if it's just like my skin. She asked if I have acne or if I have any like acne prone issues, and I told her yes, obviously, but not in my back or my glutes or anything like that. And I'm not taking anything for acne, so I don't really understand why that would happen. But she said something about like DHA and your skin. I don't even know what that means. So I was like, all right, whatever. It is what it is. But she says what's happening is not uncommon. I've never had it happen to me before, but I've always gotten sprayed. So maybe the spray when they apply it is a little different than rubbing it in and how it absorbs. But anyway, this is going to develop throughout the day. I have to head to check-ins in a little while. It starts at 2 o'clock, so I'll probably head there soon. I don't want to go there too late because I don't want to have to wait in line, but you never know, I may wait in line anyway. But I want to be in and out of there and then just come back here and chill and relax. I really don't think I'm going to go to Gold's Gym or any of that, because since I have this tan on, I don't want to even sweat a little bit. Because if I don't have to rinse this off tonight and I have any marks, then that will change how this tan looks. So I have to be very careful about clothing and protecting this tan. Like, that's why I'm in long sleeves. I have sweatpants on. I'm a little worried about how I'm gonna dress going to check-ins. I brought like a cute strapless dress, like a very like simple, just, you know, mid-length like strapless dress to wear to check-ins, just so it was easy. But I was also anticipating on doing my base coat Thursday night, last night, and having it rinsed off already, so it wouldn't really rub off on the outfit because it's like a beige outfit. But at this point, it will probably rub off on my outfit and look bad, so I could either wear this there and potentially sweat my ass off. I haven't even stepped outside yet, so I don't know how hot it is or humid or anything like that. I have sweatpants. I could wear this and make sure I protect my tan from anything and be hot and possibly sweat. Or I have a cute, like, black shorts outfit with, like, a t-shirt thing. I could wear that and maybe get something on my tan if I happen to spill water or something like that, but still be cooler. Like, I don't know what I'm gonna wear. But anyway, I should probably go outside and see what the weather is like before I do that, so then I can assess what my next decision is gonna be in terms of clothing. I mean, some people say that it's, like, a good reflection on you as an athlete to show up to check-ins and look nice and look professional, but at the end of the day, like, I've heard the judges say that that isn't gonna make or break you on stage by any means, because they're not judging you at check-ins. It's just, like, nice to show up and look nice and maybe, like, you know, show up as a professional, but in situations where you just got your tan or you're just about to get your tan, you really can't show up in nice clothing and do all that. Pro shows may be a little different in terms of, like, timing and how they do all that, but as of right now, this national show, check-ins are 2 to 6, and my tan and looking good on stage is so much more important than looking good for 2 minutes during check-ins. So yeah, I have to eat another meal soon. I've only had breakfast, and I honestly didn't even finish my breakfast. I still have a little here. I could always, like, chomp on that now, but I put an extra egg in my breakfast this morning. Well, an extra egg white, because I got a dozen eggs, so I figured might as well do 6 today and 6 tomorrow. But since I don't have my scale, I put in a baggie 120 grams of oats, so I would have 40 grams for 3 days. So I kind of guesstimated how many oats was in this. So I don't know really how many grams of oats I had in this, but again, I'm not gonna really worry about an extra 5 or 10 grams in either direction right now. Doesn't matter. But yeah, I'll probably put a little makeup on at least before I go to check-ins, because that really doesn't matter. But yeah, that's pretty much all that's going on. I'm enjoying my alone time. I'm really missing my doggies though. Last night, I was actually laying in bed after I had gotten up for the night. Like, you know, I took that nap and then I got up around 11, and then I was just laying in bed again because I was really trying to go back to sleep. So I was dozing off and coming back to, and at one point I forgot that I was here and I thought I was home, and I had my chocolate rice cakes, like, on the side of my bed, right? Like, I'm sleeping in the same position that I would sleep in at home. And my dog would always be right here, and, like, for a split second when I, like, was dozing off and, like, peeped my eyes open, I saw a black shadow, and I thought it was my dog, and I was, like, so excited, but then I realized where I was, and I was like, oh shit. You know, I really miss him. My mom sent me a couple pictures of him that I posted on the Instagram, the Peaky Wawa family, just to show everyone how cute he is, because I really miss him. But yeah, so not much else is going on right now. I will keep you guys updated when I head to check-ins.
We're at the convention center. I'm just walking to check-ins now, so getting close. Yes, I'm in the same shirt as yesterday because it's the only thing big enough to not make my tan rub off on me. So this is what it is until further notice. Hey guys, what's up? I just checked in at the Chattanooga Convention Center. It's 3 o'clock, so I got there early. There was a bunch of people there already, but there was no line yet. I know, like, a lot of the competitors and people, like the pros anyway, and I saw the coach from Team Boss Bodies, which is ironic because 5 years ago when I first started competing, when I was starting to coach people, that was the name of the team that I made, and then I kind of, like, put that to rest, and she stole it. Well, I don't know if she stole it, but she got the same name. So anyway, I saw a bunch of the girls from Team Boss Bodies there. I actually saw Jamie from Fit Body Fusion walking in as I was leaving. I didn't, like, say hi to these people because I don't know them and that would be weird, but I did see a lot of people and their teams. It's really hard to assess how people look. A lot of girls look huge and I'm like, oh my god, but you don't even know what division they're in. There's a lot of wellness girls I'm noticing, and it's pretty great because
a lot of these girls who are now doing wellness used to be in the bikini division, so now the bikini divisions are kind of shrinking a little bit and wellness is really expanding, which I love for wellness girls. I will probably never get big enough to be a wellness girl. I'm hardly big enough to be a bikini girl, but I give you guys props if you're going for wellness, because that is a hard division to develop. But I want to show you guys what I got in my little gift bag. I didn't even look through it yet. Hold on, let's just dump it all out. But it was nice, they gave us this nice like bag which has a zipper and stuff like that. So these are always good to have. Shirt, which I am so happy about. I love getting shirts from shows. We all know that. So Cheru Classic USA. If you want something you've never had, you must be willing to do something you've never done. Love that. So step one, t-shirt. What is this? Another shirt. Nice. Silverback Crew, Junior Nationals, and then it says athlete, so that's cute. I could wear that tomorrow to the show over my bikini top. Got little flyers, welcome to the NPC Junior Nationals, schedule of events, choices, tanning provided. I just want to make sure there's no athlete meeting. I don't see that there's an athlete meeting. Like I said, I messaged Junior Nationals' Instagram page, and they said that there was no athlete meeting this year. But yeah, you just want to double check. So it doesn't look like there's an athlete meeting. Whoa, got some Evogen Aminos, Tropic Thunder flavor, probably coconut, whatever flavor. Got that. Oh my god, I was so stoked for this. Yes, look at the size of this thing. OG chocolate chip with chocolate chunks. It couldn't get better for me. This is going to be amazing. I'm so excited they gave us one of these as a gift. I can't wait to split this baby open after the show tomorrow. Oh my god. This almost puts my s'mores Oreos to shame. But I'm going to enjoy those too. What else do we get here? Glam Pro. Bombshell Nutrition. Whey Isolate. Breakfast in Bed. Pancakes and syrup flavor. Interesting. So they gave us two packets of that. There's 14 grams per packet, so you probably use two, and it's like a full scoop, I'm assuming. 2 grams carbs per packet, zero fat. So these are good to have. We got a blender bottle, which I always want more of, and there's some stuff inside, which I like too. I love getting gifts. This is the best part of competing. Ooh, nice. Intro workout, lemon lime. Raw Burn Sweet Citrus. I think this is a like fat burner. Improves focus, source of energy, improves blood flow. I'll have to look up what these do. Yeah, thermogenic powder. So this is like a fat burner. Probably spicy. These are thermogenic powders like this are usually like spicy. That's the point. What else we got? Raw vegan protein in peanut butter flavor. That's cool. I never tried vegan protein before, so this will be nice. Ooh, they gave me a lot of stuff. Raw protein in chocolate. So this is isolate, not vegan. Whey isolate in chocolate. Yummy. Pre and blue punch. This feels like it's a powder, but this feels like a liquid almost. I guess it's just the air, but a pre-workout, blue punch flavor. Raw pump pre-workout, pineapple flavor. This is amazing. And some business cards. 20% off your order with code Junior Nationals. So nice. I'm excited. This was great. This was a nice little gift bag they gave us, and lots of cool stuff to be able to bring home. And it's nice that they're like sizes like this, because you could travel with them. Also, I'm a little disappointed now that I think about it, because I remember seeing on the Instagram page that there was a peanut butter company that was going to be giving out samples as well for the competitors. So I guess I didn't get that one. Maybe not everyone gets that. Probably, I don't know if anyone got it. But they gave the bags out based on the t-shirt sizes because the bags were pre-made. So since I'm a small, they gave me the small bag. So who knows. But I am more than happy with everything I got. And really, this is all that matters, is this cookie. And also, I didn't even show you guys my number. I am number 119 tomorrow. I was 113 at the last show, and I'm 119 at this show. Can't really think of any significance of it, except I'm born January 1st, 1989. But, yeah, so 119 tomorrow. And right now, I'm just chilling for the rest of the day. I was very eager to get in and out of check-ins because it is hot out, baby. It was humid as hell, and you guys saw I was wearing the same shirt I had on yesterday, that big shirt, whatever, the Goosebumps shirt, and I had my black sweatpants on. I put on like a cute workout outfit to go to check-ins, but then I was like, you know what, this is cutting way too much into my stomach. I don't want any lines. I don't need anything ruining my tan. I really don't care if I look cute for check-ins. There wasn't anyone there to worry about anyway. It's not like the judges are sitting at check-ins, like, pre-judging you there. They're not. So it doesn't matter. Be in and out, get your number, get your gift bag or whatever, and go and relax. So I don't know if I'm going to train today. I was going to go downstairs and get a little pump in. Obviously no cardio, but I'm thinking I might. I don't know if I'm going to do it or not. I'm liking how I look. I don't want to screw anything up. I don't want to, like, work out and then all this filling out kind of goes away. This won't close. But, yeah, so I'm kind of just taking check-ins about an hour after I eat. I ate a little while before I went to go check in at the hotel, at the convention center. So I came right back, threw my bikini on right before I filmed this. You guys saw the little check-in video. And I'm liking how I look. I actually spoke to the people at ProTan at the convention center just to show them what was going on with those little bumps on my butt, and they said the same thing that the girl who I texted said, that they're pretty sure after I do the top coat, it'll probably go away. But that's it for today. I'm kind of just, like I said, relaxing in this room for the rest of the night, watching YouTube and keeping my legs up and letting my body do its thing and fill out and drinking water for now. I'm almost done with my gallon. It's a little after 3, like I said, so I'm probably going to cut water around 6. Chug this gallon before then, obviously. Maybe get into the second gallon so that my body thinks that I'm drinking and it keeps, you know, I keep peeing and I keep dropping water, but I'm not taking any more in. That's how water manipulation works, if you will. I usually don't, like, cut water. I'll still sip it tomorrow through the show. But I'm not going to be, like, chugging a gallon by any means, because water will bloat you a bit if you're, like, you know, chugging it right before you go on stage. It's not a good idea, but taking sips with your meals is good. You know, like, every prep is different. Everyone's body is different. There's no one way to go about peaking for a show. It really just depends on your body, how depleted you are, how you fill out. Some people don't need a lot of carbs to fill out. Some people need hundreds of grams of carbs to fill out. It really just depends on your body. I'm trying to figure that out myself and see how much I truly need to look how I want to look. Up top, I'm liking how I look. I look full. I look nice. Well, but my glutes is really where I am the most, like, concerned. I don't think they look bad. This is the best I've looked ever for any show. I can hands down say that. I am very, very proud of everything that I've been able to achieve for myself. But you don't know who's going to show up tomorrow and how they're going to look. So I'm not really going to be focused on that tonight. I found myself again looking through the Instagram page of Junior Nationals as they're reposting everyone who's tagging them. Excuse me. And I'm falling into the rabbit hole again of going to people's pages, seeing if they're at the show, what they, you know, like, I don't want to care what anyone else looks like, because I don't think they care what I look like, and at the end of the day, I can't do anything to be like them, or look like them, or anything, and I shouldn't want to or have to. I'm happy with how I look. It's either going to be good enough tomorrow for the pro card, or it's not, so I won't know, and really, whatever is meant to happen is already going to happen. Like, it's already been predetermined. God / the universe has something destined for me. I just know that I am good enough for the pro stage. I know in my heart that my time is going to come, whether it be on Saturday or in 2 weeks or in a year or whenever it happens. I have full faith and full belief that I will get my IFBB pro card. It's just a matter of when. So I'm just excited for this journey. You know, you talk to some pros and a lot of them say, you know, don't take your time in the NPC for granted, because once you're done, you're done. The only way to go back into the NPC after you become a pro is if you forfeit your pro card. And I don't plan on doing that. And I really don't, if I get a pro card, don't plan on going through this national thing ever again. You know, like, some people will leave the NPC or the IFBB and they'll go to another federation, and that will make you forfeit your pro card. You can't compete in the WBFF and the NPC at the same time. So you have to pick a federation, you have to stay there. And for me, it's the IFBB. It always has been. It always will be. It's the best of the best. It's the top of the top. And I want to be considered one of those athletes as well. So I'm eager to get there, and I'm eager to see what the judges think and what my feedback is and what they think I should do and really take it from there, because I'm in this for the long haul. I am in this until I win this. So, like I said, whether it be this first show or down the line, I'm just prepared to do what I have to do to make the best of my time on stage and show the judges that I belong there. So I'm going to relax. I'm going to get another meal in soon. I didn't show you my second meal of the day, but I just had some jasmine rice and chicken and sea salt on top. That was it. I haven't even had any rice cakes or anything like that today. I've just been keeping it kind of small and tight with my meals. And I'm not going overboard on carbs or anything. I'm just taking it hour by hour and seeing how I look. And by the end of the night, I should be looking how I want to look tomorrow morning. And tomorrow is like, you know, some people will push the carbs and push the food up until right before the show. And that's not doing anything for your body. Like, your body is not absorbing those carbs and shuttling them into your muscle 2 hours before the show, even the morning of the show. Like, odds are that food isn't really going to make or break your physique. Your physique should be where it needs to be prior to show day. Show day is just basically getting there and fine-tuning the things like water or salt or whatever. But you should be doing that your whole peak week so that on show day there is nothing to worry about. You show up and you present your best. So that's what I'm trying to do. Just been taking, like I said, my meals meal by meal, carb by carb, bite by bite. And I'm excited. I did this all myself. I'm proud of everything that I've been able to do on my own with no guidance, no coach, no anything like that. So I have a lot to be grateful for and proud of within myself. You know, if you compared me now to me a year ago, 2 years ago, completely different person, I feel like. I feel like I've lived 1,000 lifetimes by now, but I'm finally coming back to the person that I want to be and the person I'm happy to be and I'm proud of and I can brag about, like, because she kind of disappeared for a little while and she was lost, but she's back. So, like I said, I'm here to make everyone proud. You guys have been amazing support system, and you guys have been there for me through the lows and the highs and everything. And really, like, when I win this pro card, it's for me, but it's also for you. And it's for everyone that has stood by my side and been there for me. And even when I doubted myself, you guys have been there to say that I'm good enough and I got this. So it really means a lot. So I know these clips get longer and longer the more I talk, but this is show day. This is the show day vlog, the show weekend vlog, and there's, you know, not much left to do but sit here and talk and reminisce. So I'm going to relax and maybe take a nap or something. I don't want to, like, do what I did last night and fall asleep too early and then I can't sleep tonight. So I don't know. I'm already feeling tired, but we got to work on this tan later. I can't really pass out again like I did last night, but yeah. So, that's it. I'll see you guys in the next clip. It's show day. I'm tired. It's 6:15 in the morning. The sun isn't even up yet. But I gotta start getting ready. Prejudging starts at 9. Then I have to make sure that my stomach is flat by then. I hope there's coffee downstairs by now. So I've been listening to this song for months during almost every cardio session, every prep. It's made me cry almost every time, but it fills me with the hope and the spirit and all the, like, glory that I know is already mine, that I know is already on its way to me, that I just have to be prepared to receive. I know I'm already an IFBB pro in my head. I know I'm already an IFBB pro in my actions, so now it's just a matter of time of when I'm going to be told that I'm an IFBB pro from the Federation. So I'm about to get ready and start doing my hair and makeup and get to the venue for around 9. And yeah, it's game day, baby. I'm ready. I'm feeling great. I'm drinking my coffee, and not a lot else to do except eat and get ready.
Eyeshadow fallout, it's not going to get on my concealer and get smeary and start to look muddy, so I always like to start with my eyes first, then do my brows, and then finish with my face. Hi, I'm Christina. I am an eye beauty pro. I just turned pro last show and work here in Pittsburgh, and this is my fourth show and my pro debut, so super excited about it. And I like the fact that I can take my time with my makeup, my hair, and not have...
And our judges are ready. Ladies, I'm going to pass it back to our judges table and head judge, Miss Sandy Williamson.
Thank you, Billy. I need 114, 115, 119, 121, 124, 125, 127, 134. One fourteen and one thirty-four switch. 115 and 121 switch. 115 and 121 switch. 180. Face that back wall. Face forward. One fifteen and one nineteen. One fourteen and one twenty-seven. 114 and 125. Switch right next to each other. Okay, now one more time. Let's do 180. Face that back wall. And face forward. Okay, ladies, you can file off to the left.
Competitor 122, Yandrell Holson.
Yes, I'm crying. I have to compose my thoughts and come back later to film, like, an outro. A lot just happened in, like, the past 5 minutes, so, yeah.
Guys, alright. So, this may be a somewhat emotional video. Oh my god, so many people are texting me, and I just need people to leave me alone at this point. Oh, okay, so I didn't make a video, really, after yesterday, prejudging. I don't even think I made a video after prejudging. I did on my Instagram story, but not through the vlog. So, oh, a lot happened yesterday at the show, after the show, before the show. Oh my god. So, if you hear me moaning, I will start from the end. Leaving the show, it was pouring rain, I had my rubber flip-flops on, and my Uber driver decided to drive well past me and basically drive away. And if you know how Uber works, if you're not there where they're ready to pick you up, you're getting charged and you have to call a new Uber. So although I was there, he went to a different location and blew right past me. So in the melee of trying to chase this guy down the block with my suitcases, finally get to stop him, I basically like jammed my toe in like the curb with the flip-flops on, and ooh, I saw stars, and now I can't even bend my toe, can't even move it. Been icing it off and on since last night, and today should be fun traveling home. I haven't even eaten yet, so let me take a sip of this coffee. Actually, I got a different coffee this morning, and when I came back to the room, I accidentally spilled it all over this counter here. So I had to go back downstairs and get a different coffee, and I haven't drank it yet. I have a bagel here with some cream cheese on it. I just stole these peanut butter packet things because these are just like good to have for shows and stuff. I wish I knew they were here yesterday at the show. So basically, I'll tell you guys what happened in the morning. So what I've mentioned previously in videos with my endometriosis is my biggest fear is on show day my stomach being fucked up. And inevitably it was. I wasn't able to eat anything before prejudging yesterday. I was in such a rush in the morning because my stomach was just so fucked up that I was going to the bathroom. I mean, I don't even care about being detailed at this point. Whatever, you guys are following me because you love me. So basically, between going to the bathroom 4, 5, 6 times in the morning, finishing my last coat of tan, doing my makeup, doing my hair, so much back and forth, having to be at the venue for 9 a.m. The show was running very, very fast in the morning. So I wasn't able to eat anything. I took my like supplements, my vitamins, and I had a bite of a banana just in hopes that maybe the banana would kind of settle my stomach a little and a little bit of water. I wasn't trying to drink too much water yesterday too because I didn't want to spill on my tan, and you don't really need that much water on show day. But anyway, so I get to the show and I wound up getting first callouts, which was amazing. There was 8 girls in the first callout. So when we first lined up, I was looking like top 3, and then they moved me out a spot. So it was between 5th and 6th. And then at finals, I found out that I had gotten 6th because, you know, they go to line us all up for finals, and then they wound up calling out, if I call your number, come with me. They didn't call my number. It was the top 5 girls because top 5 get to do their full presentation, whereas the rest of us just hit a front pose and exit off stage. And what I will say is for my first national show, for not having a coach, not being on a team,
not being on a team affiliated with the show, sponsoring the show, I am very proud of myself. I am very proud of being able to say that I brought myself to a sixth place position at my first national show ever, totally by myself. Like, that's something to be proud of. I obviously took it to heart yesterday. I'm still a little upset. I'm disappointed. I didn't come for sixth. But it would be naive to, and I had said this in a previous, you know, vlog, that it would be naive to assume that I'm going to go into my first national show and win my pro card. Obviously, that's the goal, but if it doesn't happen, I was prepared to do other shows after this. But now that my toe is basically broken, I don't know if I broke it or just really sprained it really, really bad. But it feels broken. So it sucks. I don't know if I'm going to be able to, I'm trying to not cry, but like literally my toe hurts so bad that I can't really do much but think about how much it hurts. Cause like it's the first toe. So after your big toe. So it really, and on my right foot. So I can't even like crack it. Like, you know, sometimes you have that feeling, that urge to just like crack your toe. And even if I go to move it, it just fucking gives me like jolts of lightning. So I might have to go to the doctor when I get home, but hold on.
So I did in fact cancel the photo shoot. I was very apologetic. I even sent him a photo of my toe so he knows what I'm dealing with. I'm probably gonna insert a little photo of what I'm dealing with myself so you guys could see the situation. I don't know if I broke it or if I just really, really, really sprained it, but my whole toe is purple down to the base. And even that base area is purple. So either I jammed it really, really good and it's all just fucked, or it's broken. I won't know till I go to a doctor, so I'm probably going to have to go to an urgent care tomorrow and see what they say. There's really nothing you can do for a broken toe, except sometimes they'll tape it to the toe next to it. But I'm going to be screaming if they even try and touch it or try and bend it, because I can't even bend it right now. It just, like, you know, sometimes you feel like you want to just crack your toe, or like, I can't even do that. And icing it is just making it worse. It just, like, I'll ice it and then my foot feels so frozen and stiff that I have to like crack it, and then I see stars. So I haven't really like moved or cracked my foot since last night, and I'm limping really bad, obviously, but sneakers are all I have to wear other than those flip-flops, which were the reason why I am in this situation. So I'm not wearing anything but sneakers today, so at least they're a little bit more protected and secured in these shoes. But it's 11:54. It's basically time to check out. So I think I'm gonna just probably go straight to the airport, and just hang out there till 5 p.m. till my flight starts, because it's not really much else I could do at this point. I'm not gonna be walking around. I need to get off my feet. I might actually have to ask for like a wheelchair or some assistance at the airport because of this. So I don't know what to do, man. This is why you need someone with you when you're traveling, just because it just helps. Having that extra person to help you carry things, even without an injury, is just so much more beneficial and just takes so much of the stress off. You know, I wouldn't have had to run to catch my Uber driver yesterday if I was with someone, because I wouldn't have had to have my bags and strolling down the street and running in the rain. Like, things just would have been so different. But I'm also believing that, you know, maybe I didn't win yesterday or place so that my family can come to a show with me in the future and be there with me when I win and be there in person and be able to celebrate with me. Because it would have been really bittersweet if I would have won and then been all by myself and come back to the room all by myself. You know, it would have been mildly depressing. So that's pretty much it. I'm about to check out. It looks like it's a beautiful day. I was told it was supposed to rain all day here today, but it doesn't look like it's going to rain. So goodbye, room. You've been fun. You've been okay, I guess. It's been a nice big hotel room. I hope they don't charge me for the mild stains on the sheets. Breakfast I didn't eat. And that's it. We're ready to go. So, I'm at the airport. I got here very early. Can't walk. Was very tempted to grab one of those wheelchairs inside, but I decided to just come outside for a little bit. very hot out, so I'm not going to be out here for long, but I'm going to just relax inside the airport. They wound up moving my flight up around 30 minutes, so that saves me a little time of waiting, which, you know, I just want to get home at this point. I just want to see my dogs and give them a kiss and give them a hug and cuddle and go to bed. I have work tomorrow, so I'm going to have to see if I'm going to work from home and go to the doctor or what, because my foot's looking really, really grody as of right now, so it really sucks. But I just had the most lovely Uber driver come here, well, pick me up from the hotel and bring me here. She was such a pleasant woman to talk to. She was from Germany, and she had stories and experiences that she was telling me about, and just very friendly. No. Not mine. Not my bag. So yeah, that's it. It's about almost 2 o'clock now. My flight leaves at 4:40, so I have a little bit of time. I'm gonna just hang out, read, get some work done, and get some food in me. Also, after eating that pulled pork last night, and mac and cheese and mashed potatoes and cookies and whatever I had, I woke up this morning looking so good, so full, like, fuck, again, another show I should have eaten my way into that I got scared and didn't, and came in too lean. But now I know, my body needs this food, it sucks it up good, it's used to eating it as a youngin', so now as an adult, it's kind of not gonna be so negative for me, so I gotta eat my way into my next show.